Welcome to this four-part video series created by the Carlsbad Fire Department to help businesses in Carlsbad reduce the risk of having a fire. Nationally, more than 7,000 restaurant fires are reported each year, with cooking equipment being the leading cause of fires. We don't want you to experience the catastrophic impacts of a fire in your business. We hope these videos will provide valuable information to promote actions that can be taken to prevent a fire from occurring and to be prepared to quickly and safely respond if one were to occur.
Hi, I'm Edie Maldonado. Your kitchen's hood and fire suppression system is designed to provide fire protection for your cooking appliances, plenum, and ducts. Your hood and exhaust system is designed to remove grease-laden vapors from the kitchen. The suppression system is designed to extinguish fires underneath your hood. Although these systems are separate, they do work together. This video will cover how these systems work, how they are maintained, and the service intervals that are required for them. The exhaust system contains many different components. One component is your exhaust fan. Your exhaust fan is typically located on the roof and will extract smoke and grease-laden vapors from the kitchen. It should be on at all times while cooking. The duct and plenum are protected by the filters. The filter should remain in the upright position at all times while cooking to prevent unnecessary grease buildup in your duct and plenum area. These capture excess grease and it collects in the grease cup. It is important to clean your filters and empty your grease cup as necessary. To maintain the efficiency of the hood exhaust system, the system should be cleaned and inspected by a licensed professional, identified by the state of California. You can check your service intervals by looking at the stickers affixed to the outside of your hood. There should be a date of when it was last cleaned, and the service of when it was last tested. Now we will talk about your fire suppression system. It extinguishes fires that are underneath your hood. It contains tanks or tanks with the solution, detection line, fusible links, and nozzles with a blow-off cap. All appliances should be located under the hood and protected by a nozzle. Each nozzle has a specifically designed spray pattern to protect the appliance that is over. If either the appliance or the nozzle is moved, the hood will not extract the vapors and the extinguishing agent will not reach the fire. For this reason, do not relocate or move your appliances without first contacting your fire protection contractor. Nozzles should always be covered with a blow-off cap to prevent orifice obstruction. If the caps are missing or damaged, they should be replaced immediately. The fire suppression system activates in one of two ways, either automatically or manually through a manual pull station. Upon activation, a wet chemical is discharged through the nozzle positioned over your appliance and will extinguish the fire. A fixed temperature heat detecting device known as a fusible link is positioned over each appliance. Automatic activation occurs when the design temperature is reached and it breaks and the system activates. The second way of activating the fire suppression system is manually. To manually activate the system, the manual pull station needs to be pulled. The pull station is located at least 10 feet from your cooking area. You must know where the pull station is and how it is used. It will need to be pulled hard enough with enough force to break the tamper seal and activate the system. To ensure your fire suppression system is maintained at proper intervals, check the tag that is located on the manual pull station. The tag will be marked with the date your fire protection contractor was last out for service. Please contact your fire protection company immediately if it is due for service. Although service professionals test and certify your system, there are steps that you could take to make certain that your system will work in the event of a fire. You should start with making sure that all equipment is located underneath your hood, nozzles appear to be in the correct location and protected with a blow-off cap, and before cooking, make sure that your filters are located in the upright position. Always make sure that excess oil and grease is cleaned up. For any questions concerning your system or service intervals, do not hesitate to contact your fire protection company or licensed hood and duct servicing company.